Day five, we woke up and it was beautiful weather again. So we just took it easy and got ourselves ready for the day ahead. Nice wide open area, old ruin here. Somebody lived there before and been fishing in the sea and there's other, sorry, nonsense. So anyway, we're coming up to a couple of miles away, I think. So we're coming up to a place called Glenballock. That'll be coming up soon. Alright buddies, the walk's not even that hard. It's just unbelievably hot right now, and it's just wearing us out. Well, me it is anyway, I don't know about Chris, but I'm fucking feeling totally fatigued. So, yeah, maybe do 4 miles at a time, break for an hour, 4 miles, break. It should be alright. I've got plenty of time, sun doesn't even go down till like 10 o'clock at night, 11 o'clock at night almost, so we can just chill. Anyway, come and get some food. Speak to you in a bit. Just on the last mile and a half, pretty much, to Kingussie. We left Newtonmore, we had some food there for the co-op, which was nice. Got sandwich and stuff like that, it was great. We're in Kingussie, so we'll have our second break, another hour. Chill out, actually have maybe some more food or stock up at least even for the night or whatever, and for tomorrow morning. But yeah, we'll decide in Kingussie where we're going to, where we're going to go, how far, see our feet are. We just stopped just briefly. We're still on this lock just now, but it's actually Lock Ganak.
Done me alright, 2 quart canteen.
But at that lock, we're just up at the top of the lock now. We're just cutting down to Kingussie now. How are you doing, Chris?
Yeah, I'm alright. I mean, the feet are a bit nippy, but it's what happens when you walk, isn't it? Like, you know.
True. Yeah,
We're what, day five now?
Day five,
so your feet are going to be nippy.
This is what, 7 miles, 7.5 miles into day five?
I think so.
Yeah, so by the time Kingussie will be about 8.5, 9 miles. Say 8 miles even.
Have a wee rest there.
Yeah, we'll spend an hour in Kingussie. What time is it now?
10 to 3.
So maybe we'll get down to Kingussie for, let's say, 4 o'clock. Leave Kingussie by 5. And then we'll maybe walk for an hour or something like that. An hour, 2 hours, maybe an hour. Depends how our feet are, no? We'll get past the Rotham Barracks and then we'll just see where we go for there. There's a bit I'd like to get to, but it's about another 5 miles away maybe. And it's like, I don't know.
The heat is just pretty bad today.
Yeah, it's just, this is the hottest day, I think, so far. And it's been hot the last few days, but it's been absolutely beltering the whole way. Yeah. We've got a bit of a breeze coming over the hill there, but I was just dying, sweating. Anyway, we'll be done in Kingussie soon enough. We've just left Kingussie. We had fish and chips there, it was pretty damn nice. Got some water, stocked up with some stuff for the rest for our feet. And now we're walking up, this is the wee walk to Rutham Barracks. Quick stop as we walk towards our final stretch for tonight, past this big stallion protecting his wife and his baby. All right, buddy. At this stage, we didn't realise that we were going to end up having to walk an extra 4 or 5 miles just to find a decent camp spot near Inch. We were kind of feeling pretty tired, our feet were sore, and the batteries on the camera were pretty much gone, so I couldn't get much footage during this stage, unfortunately.